Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you through the video lecture on the topic Engaging Adults Learners, the Principles and Practices. So we are dealing with the adult learners, the college students. And what is the principle and practice to engage the adult learners? Effectively to engage and impart knowledge to the adult learners. That is what we are going to discuss through this video lecture. And I have 30 plus years of experience in engineering colleges at various capacities. And I have published these books, Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here. Also, I am uploading the solution and discussion for the GATE question paper. And the video lectures, they are the order of the day. So, the student, they learn more through videos. So, that is the idea behind developing the video lectures and uploading in the YouTube channel. So, if you find it useful, please share with your student and subscribe the channel. Let me begin with the quote by Swami Vivekananda. You have to grow from the inside out. None can teach you, none can make you spiritual. There is no other teacher but your own soul. So, with this statement, with this positive statement from Swami Vivekananda, so let me explain the objective of this presentation. So, we, the teacher, we have to understand the principles on classroom teaching and to design the lecture in a better way and to engage the class with interest and enthusiasm. That is what the objective. So, based on the lecture, at the end of the lecture, so we'll understand the principles on classroom teaching to design the lecture in a better way to engage the class with the interest and the enthusiasm. So there is a statement, the ultimate goal of teaching is to make the new seem familiar and the familiar seem new. So new things, so whatever new technology which is coming, we have to make the new seem familiar by our teaching. At the same time, the familiar things, what is available. So, by our teaching methodology, we have to make familiar seem new. The statement is by Samuel Johnson. And objective of any teacher, teaching the student from known to unknown, teaching the student from near to far, and teaching the student from what is to what shall be. So, from the thing what they know, so we have to develop their knowledge, develop their mind to the unknown level. So, that is what the objective of a teacher. And all our design of lecture and delivery of lecture will be focusing on the principle, on this principle. There are two types of teachers who call on you when they think you know the answer, and teacher who call on you when they pretty sure you do not know the answer. Some teacher look at you and make you feel like you can do no wrong, and some look at you and make you feel you can do nothing right. So you can learn from both types, but you learn totally different things about them and yourself. So, we teacher, sometimes we always look at the student, they know well, they know everything well. Or sometimes some of the students we look at, they are useless. But that kind of approach should not be there in our view. So, all the students are equally potential, equally intelligent, and they can do better. But as a teacher, we have to identify the knowledge, interest, and intelligence within them. And we have to help them to come up in the life. We learn only from our sense organ. 1% through taste, 1.5% through touch, 3.5% through smell, 11% through hearing, 83% through sight, by seeing. And we remember 20% of what we hear, 30% of what we see, 50% of what we see and hear, and 80% what we say, and 90% what we say and do. So, these two are important. So, this is applicable for any human being. We the student, we the teachers are the student. So, we have to realize and we have to help them to learn the best and to remember the information for a longer time. Teaching adults is based on four beliefs. The first topic, the teaching adult student is based on the four beliefs. One is teaching is dialogue, learning is engagement, growth is discovery, and knowledge is application. So what is teaching is dialogue? Dialogue between teacher and student, and student and another student are absolutely fundamental to the process of teaching learning process. And learning is engagement. Student will learn better when they are engaged with the content and with the process of instruction. So the engagement of the student by active learning technique is very, very important. That is what the meaning. So we have to engage the student in the process of learning. Growth is discovery. The desire for knowledge begins with the wonder. Wow. So curiosity and is driven by need for the discovery and synthesis of knowledge. So they need the curiosity, right? So they can learn, they can grow in the process of learning when they have the curiosity. Knowledge is application. We demonstrate knowledge when we apply it appropriately and effectively. So knowledge is application. So when they apply, they can gain the skill. They learn the skill. So nowadays we are talking about the quality of anything, quality of education. We have to realize, we have to understand that quality is never an accident. It is the result of lofty intentions, persistent and sincere effort, knowledgeable self-direction and skillful applications. It will not happen as an accident. So it requires some persistent and sincere effort to achieve the quality in education. It reflects a series of intelligent choices among alternatives along the way. So the quality, we have make the intelligent choices among the alternative available for the quality achievement. So this is by William Foster. Higher education is not about rote learning and regurgitation. It is not about simply memorizing, remembering, understanding and repeating. So it is about higher order thinking. So we look at the table. Remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating and creating. These are all the six levels of cognitive skill, six levels of thinking skill. And the bottom three, remembering, understanding, applying, they are called as lower order thinking skills. And top three, they are called as higher order thinking skills. So, through education, through higher education particularly, so we have to make the student to work on the higher order thinking skill. Teaching adults is not easy as some teachers make it look. If it were easy today, then every teacher in our institution would teach equally effectively. So teaching is not easy. Teaching adult is not easy. It requires meticulous planning and implementation. Teachers who are committed to high quality instruction produce a learning environment in which students excel academically and develop personally and interpersonally. So when you are committed to be a good teacher, so you can create an ambience, environment for the student to excel in the learning process. So principle-based teaching. What is a principle? A principle is an idea that influences you greatly when making a decision or considering a matter. That is what the principle, meaning for the principle. The principle based teaching provides students with the things they need in order to succeed in their academic program. So what are the principles for teaching? Believe that they can succeed. Being treated as responsible. Knowing instruction matches the style of learning. Being engaged in the learning process. Having access to appropriate resources, the material, the book, notes and other material. Understanding what they are being taught. So we have to understand what they are being taught. Finding the course content interesting and practical. Apply learning in a variety of ways. And succeeding early in the course. So first appearance they have to make a pass. That is what succeeding early in the course. So these are all the principles in teaching the adult students. To do that, so the principle what we discussed earlier, to do that, we teachers must communicate the following message to the student on the first day of the class. I know who you are. I know what we have to accomplish. We have to accomplish, teacher as well as the student. I will present you with the choice of getting there. So ultimately, the goal of any student to make a pass in the subject right now or to score a higher grade. So there are choices, there are methodology. So we have to provide the methodology and they have to select the methodology whichever is convenient to them to accomplish the goal. I have an organized plan. So we have to give confident in the mind. I have an organized plan for delivering the lecture. I have an organized plan to make you to be successful in the course. So I will provide manageable information. Will make the work appealing and interesting. Involvement is low risk and high reward. So when you involve in the teaching learning process, it is of low risk and the student will be rewarded high. All ideas are important and valued. I will use only our time productively. I will help you to succeed. So these are all the statements we have to discuss in the first day of the class. We have to impress and create confidence in the student's mind so they can be a successful person in the course. Facilitating barrier-free learning. So barrier for teaching learning practice, what we believe. What are the barrier for teaching learning practice? Students are reluctant readers in relation to what we expect of reading behaviors of adult students. So they are not learning, they are reluctant to the reading. They are technologically dependent, some might say addict, technologically addict, but not as technologically skilled as many of us might believe. So using the mobile phone, that does not mean that they use it for, they are skilled in mobile technology, but they know how to use it and some of the students are addicted for the using of mobile phone or social media. They prefer passive learning to active learning. So they are not preferring the active learning technique. So they want only passive learning. So where they just listen to the teacher without any activity. They are dependent on teacher provided content and resources. So they are dependent. So the teacher provide notes and the information what we write on the blackboard, so they dependent on that. So they do not have habit of reading books, referring library or referring the internet for collecting information regarding the subject. That is what we believe. They have limited capacity for sustained focus, resulting in short attention span and easily distractible. This statement is very, very, very much true nowadays. So that is why we have to plan our lecture to attract the short attention span. So we supply information, we give the information, we teach in small portion, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and we will have a break, some activity in between. They are not proficient in higher order thinking, though quite capable of it. They are capable of creating, they are capable of analyzing, but they are not doing it. So they are not proficient. They find expressing idea verbally and especially transmitting knowledge in writing quite challenging. So they are not able to reproduce information on the examination paper. That is also true nowadays because of the language barrier. So many of the students, they are coming from local medium and they are not good at English. So they are not able to write the answers in the examination paper. So this is also a belief. They are increasingly anxious about the labor market and the career and may choose academic program not out of interest or passion, but because they believe that program will lead to a well-paying, secure employment. They are not coming to the college for learning, not for academic interest. So they believe that when they do well in the examination and they get a degree, they will get a well-paying, secure employment. They use transactive rather than explicit memory as their modality, meaning that if they know where to find information, they do not invest in memorizing the information. So they are not taking the information, they are not memorizing and putting the information in their long-term memory, but they know where to search. So normally when you throw a question, they will go to they do not search for the answer internally, they will search for the answer in the Google externally. So they know how to find the answer rather than they are not investing time and energy to memorize the information. And these 9 barriers, so every barrier is an opportunity for our skill development. As a teacher, as a student, every barrier is an opportunity for skill development. And each time we find the way to reduce the barrier to student learning, we reduce the barrier to our own enjoyment and satisfaction as a teacher. So we have to find the way to break the barrier to student learning and also for our own enjoyment and satisfaction as a teacher. So few questions before we take up the next principle. So we have few questions about our classroom teaching. It is not it is only to find the positive response, positive answer from the responses. Are the instructions are clear enough to be correctly understood by all the students? Remember, all the students. Is the teaching activities fair? Will all the students are able to understand and participate in the learning practice? Will the teaching stimulate curiosity and participation? Is the presentation is interesting? Is the teaching is relevant to the intended learning outcome of the course? Is it relevant to the student expectation? Is it relevant to the goal of teaching? Have I provided support for success the student in terms of information, curriculum content and interaction? So these are the questions they have to internally ask. We teachers ask about our classroom performance. So wherever we require some changes, we have to do the change for the betterment of the student. 5 essential principles of instructional practice. So these are all the principles of instructional practices: clarity, fairness, interest, relevance and support. What is clarity? Easy to follow and understand. So how do I ensure delivery and material are clear and understandable and that I know when they are not? So the clarity in our presentation. Fairness, balanced, logical, open, reasonable and non-discriminatory teachers' responses. So do I ensure that I provide individual opportunity and demonstrate a willingness to be flexible? So for every student, we have to be very fair. For every student, every individual, they are different. So we have to give equal opportunity to every student and we should be fair in dealing with the students. Interest appeals to the curiosity and attentiveness. So whether the lecture, the instruction is interesting, how do you ensure that the content and the activity motivate the student's attention and the participation? Relevance, degree of connectedness and significance. So how do I ensure that the content is relevant and how do I communicate that relevance to the students? And support, ready availability of appropriate resources. How do you ensure that I provide adequate resources and inform students of their resources available, of other resources available? So the instructional practice, so how we design, deliver and evaluate. So in there, all the three modes, three levels of our activity, there should be clarity, there should be fairness, there should be interest, there should be relevance, and there should be support. Clarity is defined as easy to understand. It is about presenting and manageable information. So in 1 period or 50 minutes, so what could be delivered, that you have to plan, that you have to plan and deliver. So we should not overload the information. So the information what we present should be manageable by the student. Clarity begins with the learning outcome and continues through the use of understandable material, text and method of delivery. Fairness is defined as balanced, open, responsive, reasonable, non-discriminatory and just practices inside the classroom or outside the classroom. Interest is defined as the degree of appeal to attentiveness and curiosity. It is about engaging students with the curriculum content through its delivery, applying a set of teaching methods interesting enough to engage participation. Relevance is defined as the degree of connectedness or significance. It is about an emphasis on essential content that is important, applicable and related to their intended learning outcome. And support is defined as the availability and promotion of assistance or resources for the particular course. And three dimensions of teaching. So we design, deliver and evaluate. So design, the things teachers to do. The things teachers do to prepare and organize curriculum, from determining learning outcome and defining essential content, how learning will be reinforced. So we have to design the lectures properly about the outcome and defining the essentials of the content, how the learning will be. So reinforcing material, so all the information whatever required to reinforce the teaching. Delivery, the things teachers do to transmit curriculum content to achieve intended learning outcome. From delivery style and modality to methods of students' engagement. So this is more the pedagogy of teaching. So we have very well prepared the notes and the notes should be effectively presented to achieve the learning outcome. Evaluation, the things teacher do to evaluate the achievement of learning outcome. Student learning and performance and the satisfaction with the course content and teacher's performance. So these three dimensions of teaching. And normally the teacher, how we spend the time? So we spend 35% to 40% in course design, 40% to 45% time in course delivery and 15% to 20% time in the evaluation per week. For example, if we work 40 hours per week in the college, so this is how we have to distribute our time for effective use of our time for the student welfare. So in nutshell, all the four things whatever we discuss, three things what we discuss, the belief, teaching is dialogue, learning is engagement, growth is discovery and knowledge is application. The five principles, clarity, fairness, interest, relevance and support, and the three delivery, three things the teacher we do, design, delivery and evaluation. So if you connect everything correct, a supportive and engaging learning and teaching environment will be available for the student to excel in their field of learning. So psychology of teaching, tell them what you are going to tell them, then tell them what you told them. So this is what the simple three statements for our classroom teaching. So before you start, you tell them what you are going to tell them. That is the objective of learning, objective of this class or outcome of this class. Then you tell them. Then you tell them what you told them. That is highlighting or reviewing what we taught in the classroom. That is what the first statement. I hear, I forget. I see, I remember, I do, I understand. So the, if you want to student to understand things, you have to give opportunity to do things. So tell me, I forget. Show me and I remember. Involve me and I understand. So involving the student in the learning practice, in the learning activity, learning process, so that will make them to understand well the subject. So with this, I stop you. Thank you. If you find the video is interesting, share with your friends and subscribe to the channel. Thank you. We'll meet again with other interesting topic in future.